Hello students. So in the last class we have discussed about 1D array and 2D array. So I have already told 1D array programming in the class as well as. So now I am going to explain 2D arrays, how a programming will be there and how to write a program. Okay, so now we'll start with the programming in 2D array. So next, so here first I'll start with a simple program where to read a 2D dimensional array and to read elements into 2D dimensional array and to print element into print from the elements from the 2D dimensional array. So we'll start with that. Okay. Next we'll see a simple example program on 2D array. So what is that is to read a simple elements into 2D array, integer array, and printing them onto the screen. Okay. So that you'll understand how to read the elements dynamically from the 2D array and how to print the elements onto the screen. Okay. So I'm starting with a simple example program. So, hash include std.h. So everyone know this statement. So why we write? So I'm including a standardized input output header file because of having input standardized input output function may have in the program. Without scanf and printf, I cannot do any program. That's the reason I've included standardized input output function. Okay, next. So this is, you know, already so without main we cannot write a C program. So I'm taking a default return type int, and a main is my main program. I'm starting with everything I'm writing in main program only. That's the reason I've taken main. So next thing is, so how to declare a two-dimensional array. So what is that declaration syntax? Data type. So declaration syntax is data type, and so what is array name and a row size and column size. So see, I'll declare. So here I'm declaring int a of 3 by 4, that is a row size. 3 is my row size, 4 is a column size, and a is my name of an array. So where I and j are the two iterative variables to read values. Okay, so next, what is the next thing I'm going to take? So when I declare a of 3 by 4, how many variables will be created? So 12 variables. So that is 12 variables will be created. So how it will be created? 3. So 3 rows and 4 columns. 3 rows and 4 columns. 3 by 4. How many variables will be created? 12 variables will be created. That is total 12 elements will be created. So what are that variable names? a of 0, a of 0, 1, a of 0, 2, a of 0, 3, a of 1, a of 1, 2, a of 1, 3, a of 2, 0, a of 2, 1, a of 2, 2, and a of 2, 3 are the element, the variable names which will be created when I declare a of 3 by 4. So a of 3 by 4, so why these 12 elements will be created? So this is the 0th row, and this is 1th row and 2nd row, that is 2th row. So this is 0th column, 1th column, 2th column, 3rd column. So why, sir, we are starting with a 0? So every index of an array will start with a any index will start with a 0. That's the reason we are starting with a 0. So 0 is a 0, the first row, first column, second column, third column, and fourth column. So how many columns are there? 4 columns. So how many rows are there? 1, 2, 3. So 0th row, first row, 2, second row. Okay, these are the variables will be created when I declare a of 3 by 4. When I declare a of 3 by 4, that is 3 rows and 4 columns. So these are the variables will be created automatically in the background. So as you know, when I write a of 3, when I take one dimensional a of 3, how many variables will be created? 4 variables, of which only linear fashion. So all these variables will be created the linear fashion. This is the 0th element, and this is the first element, this is the second element. So how many elements are? 1, 2, 3 elements will be created. Likewise, when I write a of 3 by 4, how many elements will be created? 12 elements. That means with a single name I'm going to create a more variables, and it makes us too easy to calculate in which two-dimensional way of things. So if at all if you have anything of two-dimensional way, it makes us too easy to calculate, easy to compute anything or a mathematical or anything which is of two sided, that is rows and columns. So whereas one dimensional array will be only linear fashion, linear things, whereas two-dimensional array will be in two dimensions. Where is rows and columns? Row size, row wise, and column wise. That's the reason we are going to take two-dimensional arrays. And these two-dimensional arrays are very, very useful in the calculating. Very useful in the calculating our matrices and in mathematics. Okay. So next we'll see. So when I've created these elements, so now my work is to read the values into these variables. Yes. So these variables loki nenu values read cheyali. My work is now to read the values into these variables. How it can be done by using a nested for loop, I can make possible of reading elements, that is reading values into these variables. How it will be done, we'll see it. Okay, first I'm asking a user to enter. This is my statement to enter the elements so that user will understand to enter the elements. So as you wish, customized message to user so that you will understand to enter the elements. So that's the reason I've written. So if you want to read, you can write. Which way you want to write, you can write. So I wrote enter the array elements so that you'll understand. Okay, now I have to enter the array elements. You will enter the array elements. Next, what is the next statement I will write? So for. So because for nested for loop is best thing to read array elements. How it be done? So see here. So when I write i equal to 0. So I will 0 is less than 3, it is true. So 0 is less than 3, it is true. So when it is true, it goes to the next statement. J value is also 0. So next 0 is less than 4. It goes to the next statement. What is that? Scanf percentile d a of 0, 0. Obviously, it is the first element. I'm going to read a first element. I'm going to read a first element. Let's see. So again, I'm explaining. So when I've taken i equal to 0, so 0 is less than 3. Yes, it is true. So net, if it is true, for loop goes to the next statement. What is the next statement again? For j equal to 0. So j less than 4, j plus plus. That is, so j value is initialized again with a 0. So why I'm initializing starting with 0? Because array indexes always starts with a 0. Array indexes always start with a 0. So 0 is less than here. So 0 is less than 4. So 0 is less than 4, obviously it is true. So if it is true, next it will go to the next statement. What is the next statement they have here? So scanf percentile d ampersand a of 0, 0. So what is the use of scanf? Scanf is to read elements from the output screen. Output screen launchi elements read cheyadaniki we are using a scanf function. That is, scanf function is used to, it is a predefined function to use the elements, to read the elements from the output screen. So whereas it becomes, what is the statement? It becomes percentile d comma ampersand of a of 0, 0. Obviously I'm going to read which element? The first element I'm going to read. So what happens in the next thing? What happens? Goes again, next thing, scanf. We have completed all the statements here. So it goes to the next statement here, or next it here. It goes to the first for loop only, because this for loop only, nested for loop only. Because why? We didn't complete this. We have didn't complete this loop. We didn't break out of this loop. That's the reason we are not going out of this. When we break out of this loop only, we go for the first for loop. So that's the reason. What happens now? J value becomes 1. It updates to 1. So 1 is less than 4. Yes, it is true. Yes, 1 is less than 4. It is true. So it goes to the next statement. What is the next statement? Scanf percentile d ampersand a of. So 0, 1. So 0 and 1. What is, obviously it is the second element. So second variable. So now we have read the value into the second variable. So next it becomes 2. 2 less than 4. It is true. Yes. So it becomes 0, 2. What is the next variable? It is next variable. A of 0, 2. This is the third variable I'm going to read. The next, whenever I've taken again, next, J value becomes 3. When J value becomes 3, what happens? J equal to 3. So 3 less than 4. It is true. Obviously true. Next, it goes to the next statement. What is the next statement? So scanf percentile d. Ampersand a of ij. What is ij? So i value, does i value change? No, i value is same. So So I value is 0 and j value becomes 3. So AF03, what is AF03? The next element, next variable. So I'm going to do AF03, done. So next, what happens next? Next it goes to the, next it becomes, j value becomes, what j value becomes? J value becomes 4. So j is 4. So 4 less than 4. What is the 4 less than 4? It is false. When it is false, it comes out of this block, this for loop block. If I come out of this for loop block, does we have any statement? No. After this statement, where does cursor goes again? It goes to your first for loop. What is the first for loop? I equal to 0. I less than. So already I value is 0. So now I plus plus. I becomes what? I value becomes what? I value becomes now 1. What is that? I value 1. I value is equal to 1. 1 less than 3. Yes, it is true. If it is true, again, this loop starts. Which loop starts? Again, for this for loop. Which for loop? J for loop starts and it will start with a, so the j value is again is equal to 0. It starts with a 0 and a 0 less than 4 and j plus plus. It not goes. So it goes to the next statement. Sorry, it goes to the next statement. What is the next statement? Percentile d ampersand a of 1, 0. Because I value is changed. I value, what is I value? 1. I value 1, a of 0. So what is, which element this is? This is the, this element. A of 1, 0. Next, j value becomes 1. So we have 1, 1. Which element this is? Next. Next j value becomes 2. Next j value becomes 3. Next j value becomes 4. And it, what happens when j value becomes 4? It comes out of this for loop. So if it is, if I'm coming out of this for loop, then coming out of this for loop, what happens? Again it goes to the next. What it goes to the next for loop. What happens? I value becomes, again I value becomes 2. And j values again starts with a 0. So in that statement, what happens? Scanf becomes again AF20. I'm going to write AF20. Next, j value will be updated. AF21. Next, j value will be updated. AF22. Next, j value will be updated. AF23. And so on. Likewise, I'm going to read all the elements in this for loop. All the elements in this for loop. Okay? Did you get it? Yes. I'm thinking that you have got the concept that nothing. So we are taking a for loop, that is nested for loop, and going to read all the variable values, how many variables which are created by this array, this two dimensional array. I'm going to read that elements. So simple logic. What is the simple logic here? What is the logic here? So first for loop, this for loop for the reading a row wise, this for loop for reading elements column wise. So based on that, however, we write scanf statement. Scanf statement is to read elements into the array. So that's it. Okay. So I think you have understood. So now we have read all the elements. What are the elements we have read? AF00, AF01, AF02, AF03, AF01, 110, AF11, AF12, AF13, AF20, AF21, AF22, and 23. So these are the elements I have read by using which statements. These are the blocks. So whenever you want to read all the elements into two dimensional array, you are to supposed to write which logic. This is the logic to write for I equal to 0, which 3 is the, which size, this is the row size, and for j equal to 0, j less than 4, 4 is which size, column size. That's it. Keep in mind that this will be row size, this will be column size. If you want to read all the elements, so only remember that if you want to read all the elements of a 2D array, we have to write which logic. This is the logic, this is the best logic for I equal to 0. So this is the first for loop, this is for reiterating a row loop, this is for iterating a column loop, row loop and a column loop. Just remember this. So by this, we are going to read the elements into by this logic. Only this logic is used to. So remember this logic. This logic is used to read the elements into the two-dimensional array. Okay. So next. So now, so I've read the elements. Now, my what is my program? To read the elements into array and print the elements from the array to the output screen. So now, I'm going to print the values onto the screen. What are that? I'm going to print, so same values, what are the same values I've read into this values. For example, I've read the values into here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I've read the values. For example, think that I've read the values 1 into the AF00, 2 into the 01, 3 into 02, 4 into 03, 5 into 10, 6 into 11, 7 into 12, 8 into AF13, and 9 into 20, 10 into 201, so 11 into 22, 12 into a of 2, 3. Then how I'm supposed to print the values? By print statement. Which print statement? Printf. If I want to print this value, printf percentile d, a of 0, 0. So if I print if a of 0, 0, it automatically prints which value? 1. If I write a of 0, 1, it automatically prints 2. If I write a of 0, 2, it prints 3. If I write as a of 0, 03 here, prints value 4. Likewise, I have to print all the elements. To print all the elements, how to write a same? So I have to iterate all the variables again. Same variables I have to iterate. So how I have iterated all these variables by using which thing I have iterated? Nested loop only. So same thing, I'm going to use that logic. Which logic I'm going to use? Same nested loop I'm going to use. And same. Say for I equal to 0, I less than 3. For j equal to 0, j less than 4, printf percentile d slash t af I af is instead of scanf I wrote only printf. So here I wrote a slash t because it has to print a space between every element. So I have done. Next. So return 0, next close. So what I have done? Simple. I have taken a nested for loop to read the elements. I have taken a nested for loop to print the elements. So why we have taken nested for loop? We have to iterate all the elements, which are columns and a rows. First row wise, and a second row and third row. Likewise, to iterate from the row wise elements, I have taken the nested for loops. So just a simple logic. All the elements we have to iterate from row wise and column ones. This is a row, first row and first column. First row, second column. First row, third column. First row, fourth column. Likewise, to iterate all the elements, I have taken the nested for loops. Okay. So by thinking that you have understood this concept, and we'll go with the next example. Which example I'm going to read is addition of matrices and multiplication of matrices. So here I'll change. I'm coming to same example. For example, so here I have taken this 3 by 4 are the 3 and 4 are the 3 is what is 3? 3 is the row size, 4 is the column size. If at all I want to ask a user to enter a 3 by 4, that is, I'm not going to give a constant row size and constant column size. I want to change my row size and column size whenever I execute this program. So whenever I execute this program, I want to change the row size as well as column size. I want to ask a user which row size and which column size you want to choose. So that's the reason here what I'll do is I'll take a maximum size of row size and column size A of 10 by 10. If I write A of 10 by 10, what happens? How many variables will be created? 100 variables will be created. So here if I write a simple matrix multiplication or matrix addition, I'm not going to use a 10 by 10 row size. I'll use 5 by 5. So it only uses 25 variables or 50 variables like that. So I'm not going to use 100 variables. That's the reason I'll make maximum size of variables. Sorry, 100 by 100 or 10 by 10, your wish. How much size you can take? You can take one way. This is the one way. So take a maximum size of variables and ask a user to read n value or m value. So n value or m value or r value or c value. Ask a user to enter r value or c value and read the values from the user and replace instead of here row and here column. Row and column. So that's the reason. So everything is same, but you have to change only row size here, column size. What's the row size you will enter by the user? What's the column size you will enter by the user? We don't know. So that's the reason. So instead of constant value of 3, you change r value, write here r and write here c, and write here r, write here c. Just that the thing you have to change. R and c values read from the user. Before this, what you do is instead of entering elements, printf. Enter row size, column size. So now user will understand. So now you read that scanf percentile d ampersand r and ampersand c. So now what happens? So you have row size, column size that has entered by the user, and instead of that you replace here R and C. That makes your program dynamically changing your row size and column size whenever you execute the program. So whenever you execute the program, you can change your row size, or you can change your column size automatically if you want wish to change your column size and row size when you execute the program. Okay? So this is a simple change how you can make a program dynamically. So there is also another example also there. Instead of taking maximum size, you should not declare here. You declare what you declare is just declare row variable and column variable and read the row variable and column variable. Declare after reading the row variable and column variable, you can declare int a of row and column. That is also another possible, but it's only possible in the after C99 version. C99 version. If your compiler is after C99 version, it will be applicable only if you have this way. Okay, this is another way to make a dynamic variable. But my best suggestion is to declare maximum size of your row size and column size. You read from the row variable and column variable from the user, and you change that row variable and column variable. So this is a simple example to read the array values from the user. So array elements from the user and print 2D array elements from the user and print onto the screen. Okay, now we'll see second example program, matrices addition. So first we'll see how matrices addition will be there. After that we'll go with a programming example. So first of all, we'll see how a matrix addition will perform. So I think you all know how a matrix addition will be done. So in the previous maths also you know how to addition will be done. So we'll see first what is the concept behind the matrix addition. First, I have A of 3 by 3, that is 3 rows of 3 columns of square matrix A matrix. So what are the elements there inside of that? So A of 0, 0, A of 0, 1, A of 0, 2, A of 1, 0, A of 1, 1, A of 1, 2, and A of 2, 0, A of 2, 1, and A of 2, 2. These are the elements inside this A of 3 by 3 matrix. A of 3 by 3. How many rows? 1, 2, 3. 3 rows and 1, 2, and 3 columns. This is 0th row, 1th row, and 2nd row. So this is 0th column, 1th column, and 2nd column. These are the 3 rows and 3 columns of first matrix. So let's take, this is my first matrix. A is the first matrix, and let's take another matrix, B. B is another matrix. So that is the, what are the elements inside of B? Same way. What are the elements? B of 3 by 3. So 0, 0, B of 0, 0. And B of 0, 1, B of 0, 2, B of 1, 0, B of 1, 1, B of 1, 1, 2, B of 2, 0, B of 2, 1, B of 2. These are the elements inside of my second matrix. So then how a matrix addition will be performed? So addition of these two be added into the third matrix, that is A matrix plus B matrix is equal to third matrix, E of 3 by 3. So this is my third matrix. So then we'll see how it will be performed. So if I add A plus B, so I'll get a third matrix of C of 0, 0, C of 0, 1, C of 0, 2, and C of 0, 1, C of 1, 0, C of 1, 1, C of 1, 2, C of 2, 0, C of 2, 1, C of 2, 2. These are the my elements to be done. So then how the addition to be performed? So this addition of C of 0, 0, the value should be getting a C of 0, 0 to be added with A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. If I want to get this element, I would add A of 0, 1 plus B of 0, 1. So these two elements to be added. Next, if I want to get C of 0, 2, C of 0, 2, I want to add A of 0, 2 plus B of 0, 2. These two elements to be added. Next, if I want to get the C of 1, 0, I should add A of 1, 0 plus B of 1, 0. That means likewise, how it goes, C of 0, 0 to be getting. If I want to get this element, I want to add A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. So, if I want to get C of 0, 0, sorry, C of 0, 0, if I want to add, I would add A of 0, 0, B of 0, 0. So, C of 0, get the answer of this, and add this plus, add this element. So likewise, if I want to get the second element, so I would add C of 1, 0 to get C of 1, 0, so I would add A of 1, 0, 1 and B of 0, 1. This has to be done. So what is that? This. So C of 0, 1 equal to A of 0, 1 plus B of 0, 1. So likewise and so on last element. What is the last element? C of 2 is equal to A of 2 plus B of 2. So A of 2 is equal to A of 2 plus B of 2. So these two elements to be added. Likewise, every element has to be added for the addition of two matrices. So how we'll do that? We'll see in the program. Okay. Next. So first statement, you know what is first statement? Ash include str dot h. Next statement, int main. So main is my main function and int is my default int return type. And I'm declaring three matrices. Why I'm declaring three matrices sizes? 3 2D arrays is why. So A of 3 3 is first and B of 3 3 is second and C of 3 3 is the resultant matrix. I'm going to store the result of A plus B. The result of A plus B I'm going to store into C. So that is the reason I've taken 3 2D arrays. Okay. Next, so what is the next? I is for iterating row size and J for iterating column size. Okay, next. So I'm asking a user to enter. So however, user has to enter the element. So we have to give a message to user such that so we will know where to enter the elements. Okay, so that's the reason I'm writing enter the first matrix element. So he has to enter the first matrix. I have to read them. How to read again? So how to read the 2D array elements? This is a of 3 by 3 is a 2D array. Yes. How many rows? 3 rows. How many columns? 3 columns. I have to write which logic for I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, and for J equal to 0, J less than 3, J plus plus, and scanf percentile d ampersand a of I j. If I'm reading the first matrix, it is a of I j. So if I'm reading the second matrix, b. So which name you are given for the which type of matrix, and which that name you have to change it. Okay, so this is a what is this? This is a nested looping to read a 2D array. So however, A of 3 3 is a 2D array, B of 3 3 is a 2D array, C of 3 3 also 2D array. For that, to read the elements into that, how we have to write? What is the logic behind that? For I equal to 0 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, open brace. For J equal to 0, J less than 3, J plus plus, open brace, scanf. What is this scanf? Percentile D ampersand A of I j. A of I j is the so logic for that. Reading the elements into two-dimensional array. We'll see that. What is that first statement? For I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, and for J equal to 0, J less than 3, J plus plus, scanf, percentile D, ampersand A of I, J, and close. So this, what is the need of this for loop? To read row by row. To read row by row. Where 3 is my row size. To what is the need of this for loop? To read column by column. So column wise. So what is the size of this 3 is the size of column size. Okay, next, scanf. However, you know scanf is a function, predefined function to read elements. What, which element I'll read here? Which element by element I'll read? A of 0 0 first element, A of 0 1 second element, A of 0 2 is a third element I'm reading in the first row. So next row, what is the next element I'll read? A of 1 0. So next element, A of 1 1. A of next element, A of 1 2. What is the next element? A of 2 0. Sorry, this is 2 0. A of 2 1. Next element, A of 2 2. These are the elements in the matrix. Which matrix? A matrix. That is A 2D array. So A of 3 by 3, if it is A of 3 by 3, how many variables will be created? 9 variables will be created. Total 9 variables will be created. I have to read 9 variables, 9 elements into these 9 variables. How I am reading that? By using a nested for loop. By using a nested for loop, I am reading that elements into these variables. Okay, this is clear to you. And so I have read the first matrix. So what is the logic behind it? First, for the matrix addition, what is the logic? I have to read A matrix and I have to read a B matrix, and for this addition of A matrix plus B matrix, I'll get a C matrix. So this is my logic. So first, I've read the A matrix. Then what is the next thing I have to do? I have to read a B matrix. What is, how I have to read? Same thing. Next, I'm reading a second matrix. But to read a second matrix, what the thing I need? So same thing, how I have read for the first matrix, how did I read from first matrix? By using a nested for loop. The same logic I'm going to use for reading a second matrix. How I'm going to read for I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, for j equal to 0, j less than 3, j plus plus, scanf percentility, ampersand b of ij. So this is a second matrix, same thing. So what is the logic written here? The same logic written here. But what is the difference here? Here I've read here A, I've read here B. Instead of A, it is B only, just. So in the same way, how A matrix will have A of 0, 0, and so on, A of 2, 2. The same way, how many variables will be created for A, that many variables will be created for B. The same thing. That's the reason I didn't change my row size and column size. And the same thing I've declared for this. So same thing. Here also, B of 0, 0, and so on, B of 2, 2. So same elements. How many number of elements will be created? 9. So total 9 variables will be created. I have to read 9 variables in this first matrix and 9 elements to be read from this second matrix. So if you have customized, if you want to customize the number of elements to be read, so you customize these for loops and customize your scan. So based upon which element, how many number of elements to be read, you customize based upon your logic. Okay, next. What is the next thing I have to do? I have read the A matrix. So A matrix I have read. I've read the B matrix. Next thing I have to do, I have to add A plus B is equal to C. So last thing we have seen, the last slide. What is the last slide we have seen? To add C, to get the C of 0, 0, to get the C of 0, 0, what I have to do? I have to add A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. I'm going to write the same logic for the addition of two matrices in the next programming. Okay, sir. Okay, we'll see that. Now I've read the A matrices and B matrices. So what I'm doing here, addition of A plus B. So now for I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, for j equal to 0, j less than 3, j plus plus. Okay, in the last slide we seen that addition of A plus B, how it is be done. Addition of A matrix plus B matrix, how it is done. So to get the C of 0, 0, what has to be done? A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. Sir, what is this A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0? This is the first element of first matrix, that is first array, and first element of second matrix. To get the first element in the resultant matrix, I have to add the first element in the first array and first element in the second array. Likewise, to get the second element in the resultant matrix, I have to add second element in the first matrix plus second element in the second matrix. Likewise, I have to add all the elements to get this. How I can do that? By same logic. What is the logic here written here? Nested for loop. By using a nested for loop only, I have to repeat the same statement by using iterative variables. By repeating iterative variables, I'm going to do that. I'm going to do how? For I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, for j equal to 0, j less than 3, j plus plus, c of ij equal to a of ij plus b of ij. How it will be worked? First and foremost, I value becomes 0. What is I equal to 0? I equal to 0. And the next, 0 is less than 3. Yes, 0 is less than 3. It is less than 3. If it is less than 3, what happens? It goes to the next statement. What is the next statement? 0. J is equal to, j is again 0. Again it is 0. So 0 is less than 3. 0 is less than 3 and it goes to the next statement. What is the next statement? If it is true, it goes to the next statement. What is that? So C of 0, 0 is equal to, so same thing. I value is 0 and J value is 0. C of 0, 0 equal to A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. I have to add A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0 is equal to C of 0, 0. The same statement. What do you written here before? C of 0, 0 is equal to A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. Same statement. To get the C of 0, 0, A of 0, first element of resultant matrix, I'm adding the first element of first matrix and first element of second matrix. Likewise, it will be repeated until unless I'm getting C of 2, 2 is equal to A of 2, 2 plus B of 2, 2. So this up to until unless we are getting in this matrix, it will go up to last element. What is the last statement? And it will be getting out of this nested for loop and we'll be calculating addition of matrices. Here, okay, done. we have done addition of matrices. Next, what we have to do? Yes, we have taken A matrix, we have taken B matrix, and we have done C equal to A plus B. Yes, we have done it. Then what is the next thing we have to do? It print a C such that I will know the result. Yes, to print a C such that I will know the result. So see, if I print a C only, I will know the result. User know the result. So until unless if you are not printing the C value, user can't know that what is the result you have got. He doesn't know. So sir, that's the reason I have to print the C value. How to print a two-dimensional array again? Take a for loop, nested for loop, and print the value. Nested for loop and print the value. Okay, we'll see how it is done. So printf resultant matrix is, so I've taken the nested for loop, printing a matrix C of ij. But the same logic I'm going to use, which I've used to print the matrix. But I have written an extra statement. What the extra statement I have written? See here, see printf percentile n. Why sir? Why this percentile n? To print a resultant matrix in the matrix form, resultant array in the matrix. So however, this is an array, so values will be array. But to print them in the matrix form, so how matrix form, how matrix will be there? C of 0, 0, C of 0, 1, and C of 0, 2, so C of 1, 0, C of 1, 1, 1, 1, C of 1, 2, C of 2, 1, C of 2, 1, C of 2, 2. So I have to print the matrix in the row wise, that is, so row by row. So first row, after completing the first row, I have to come into the next statement, that is next line. So after printing the first statement, I have to come to the next line, so new line. So to get the new line, again I have to write a slash n. To get the new line, what I have to write? Slash n. So whenever I print the values after printing a first row, what happens? C of 0, 0, C of 0, 1, C of 1, 0. So it j value becomes 3, and we come out of the next block, we come out of the next line. What is the next line here? Printf slash n. Printf slash n. Slash n means we are printing the next line. To print the next line, I have written printf. That's the reason to print a matrix from, I've only written this printf slash n. Printf slash n. I'm printing this next line. After the next, what happens? After printing the first row, to print the first row, this nested loop will be used. After printing the first row, I have to come here, printf slash n. It comes up the next line. The command comes here, and it will be there here. Cursor will come here, and it will be there. After that, we are going here again. We are going here. I value will be changed. I value becomes 1. I value becomes 1. Again, it will be printing. So next row. So next second row. Second row will be printed. After second row, I have to print a new line. So to print a new line, to come out of the next loop, next line, I'm writing a printf slash n. So that means after every row completed, after every row printed, to print in the next row, in the next new line, I'm writing a printf slash n. So to get a matrix form, I'm writing a printf slash n. That's the reason I've written a slash n here to print a new line for every row. After printing every row, to print a new line row by row, I've taken a printf slash n. Why I've taken, so for example, inner block of the for loop. What is inner block of the for loop? Just why didn't give open brace and close brace? Because after this for loop, only one statement. But for this for loop, how many statements are there? Three statements. For this, I've given open brace and close brace. But for this for loop, I didn't give an open brace and close brace because I have only one statement after this for loop. So automatically this for loop will be applicable for which for loop? This for loop one. That's the reason I didn't give open. If you want to open and close, you can open and close. But explicitly I didn't open and close because it is okay. If I'm not opening a close also, this for printf will be applicable for this for loop. Okay. So next, after coming out of this block, it automatically comes to the next statement. What is the next statement? Slash n. That means after printing, when I come out of this for loop, after printing the first row, I'll come out of this block. So after coming out of this block, what is the statement for? So printf slash n. Printf slash n. Slash n means to get to print the next line in the new line. That means after printing this, does we have any other statement? No, I didn't have any other statement. I value will be updated. I value becomes 1. And again, this for loop will be repeated. That means I am printing this row, the second row. again after this block, when this block will be completed after getting out of this, so after printing this row, the block will be false. That means whenever I come out, j value is equal to 3, it come out of the block. Next, this block, we come out of this block. But after coming out of this block, what we have is this statement, printf statement. What is the printf statement? Printf, so new line, that is new line, the next, the line will be printed into the new line. So we come out of the this line. So we come, so next line will be printed here. Due to that, the next cursor will be here and it will be a new statement. After that, again, it goes to the new I value becomes 2. Again, this for loop will be repeated. Again, this for loop will be repeated. Again, the row will be printed. After that, it is new line. I don't need. So after that, after new line, I value becomes 3 and we come out of this block. So where that means we are printing the elements in the matrix form. That's the reason I've taken this logic. I've taken this logic because to print my elements in the matrix form. First element will be printed here. Next element, after next element, this space. Because I've given a space, after that it will be printed here. After that it will be printed here. So after that, what happens? J value becomes 3 less than 3, false. It comes out of the, so we come out of the block. And after this block, what is the statement we have? Printf slash n. That means I am coming to the here. So new line. I am going to the new line. Going to the new line. After new line, I value will be updated. I value will become 1. Again, this for loop will be repeated. I am printing here. Next printed here. Next printing here. After that, it j value becomes false. J becomes false. J loop will become false. And we come here and printf. We come here. The cursor will be here. The cursor will be here. Next I value will be updated to. And it will be printed here. J well, so this for loop again will be repeated here, 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 and again we come here, printf slash n. This cursor will be here. Okay, so that's the reason. So we have taken a printf in the new line. Okay, so okay, this is a logic to print a matrix form. Print a 2D array in the matrix form. Okay, did you get this? Okay, so after this, so some of the members will be writing the printf statement here itself, because printf here only, if I write printf to print a matrix, that is output, some members will write here only percentile t slash t c of ij. It is also correct, good and correct. But if I write like this, what happens is in some cases if you write in the function form, it is not good practice to write here only. So it's correct as per logically, it is correct if you write here. What happens if you write here? If you write here and open brace and close brace, you have to close brace, because after that you have to write here printf slash n, because without writing that we cannot print in the matrix form. That's the reason. That means how people will write is instead of writing this again, they'll write all the statements, they mix up this block and this block, because this for loop and this for loop is same, and this for loop and this for loop is same, and you are only writing c of ij and printf. So these two statements will be mixed in one block, and they will be printing and writing in another block. So if you write like this, it is okay for this addition, but it is not okay for multiplication. How the people write is for I equal to 0, I less than 3, sorry, I less than 3, I plus plus, open brace, for j equal to 0, j less than 3, j plus plus, open brace. We have to open brace, compulsory you have to open, because I am writing here two statements inside of this block. What is the statement? C of ij equal to A of I j plus B of I j. These two statement. Again, another statement. What is another statement? Printf percentile d slash t C of I j. What is the logic here? So here only I am calculating, and after that printf slash n close. So that means I am calculating addition here, again I am printing first element addition, that means I'm calculating the first element of this resultant matrix, I'm printing that first element. I'm calculating the second element of this resultant matrix, I'm printing the result. I'm calculating the third element of this resultant matrix, I'm printing that. I'm calculating the fourth element, I'm printing that. Fifth element, printing. Sixth element, printing. Seventh element, printing. Printing, calculating, printing, calculating, printing. That means after first element only printing, second element printing, third element printing. That means here only I'm calculating and here only printing. So without here, what is this logic is, after calculating all these elements, I'm printing in matrix form. But here, what is this logic? I'm printing, I'm calculating first element to addition, printing that element. Second element addition, printing that. Third element addition, printing. Fourth element printing. Fifth element printing. Likewise, all the elements. So one by one. Printing, so calculating, printing, calculating, printing, calculating, printing, calculating, printing will be done by this logic. So if you do like this logic, calculating all the elements of addition and printing that all elements at a time in the matrix form. But here what you are doing is calculating addition, printing, calculating addition, printing, calculating addition, each element by one by one, each element by one by one. So what is the disadvantage of this is nothing. If you can write, if you can do that way, or you can do this way. Disadvantage is we cannot do this thing in the matrix multiplication, because the multiplication will be different and addition will be different. That's the reason I'm telling you to follow this logic, because it will be block by block. You understand what is a block by block? So understand is first reading a matrix, reading a b matrix, addition of c equal to a plus b, next printing c. So you'll understand, okay, this is a block for addition, sorry, reading A matrix, this is a block for reading B matrix, this is a block for addition of C equal to A plus B, this is a block for printing a C. So it will be easy to remember also, and it will easy to make easy. So it will be common for everything. It is common for everything. This is a common, and you have to change only a scanf statement. Here you have to change only one. Here A, instead of A, you have to write B. So instead of C of A plus B, so instead of scan, if you have to write C equal C of ij equal to A of ij plus B of ij. And here simply change one statement. What is that to print, you know, however to print, you know, and you have to write extra statement called print a percentile list action. Everything is same for nested for loop, nested for loop, nested for loop. Everywhere you have to write a nested for loop. So simple logic you can remember. So make a remember of logic. It will make easy to do this way. You can also do that way also, but this is better way of writing a program addition. Okay, program of addition. So this is, I've done here logic which is of static size. So where my size of, whenever I execute this program, only my size will be executed 3 by 3 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 3 by 3. But if I want to change the size of my matrix, what I have to do, I have to increase your size. Whenever you are declaring your arrays, 2D arrays, you maximize your size 10 by 10 or 10 by 10, 10 by 10, 10 by 10. So you maximize the size and you read this row size and column size from the user. If you are doing addition, so addition of matrix, you have to remember that one logic. What is the logic? The addition only possible if the size of A is equal to size of B. That means, so if at all A size is 3 by 3, the B size should be also be the 3 by 3. So that means row size of this is equal to the row size of B. The row size of column, row size of A matrix is equal to row size of B matrix. Column size of B matrix is equal to column size of A matrix is equal to column size of B matrix. That is, if at all, if I am taking A matrix is 2 by 3, the B matrix size also should be there 2 by 3. So you have to check this condition also before doing addition. Whenever you go by your dynamic size variable, dynamics R1 C1 R2 C2, if you are taking R2 C2 different sizes for different matrices, you have to check the condition. If R1 is equal to R2 and C1 equal to C2, if you check after this checking condition only, you read the, before only you read the R size, row size, column size. Column size, row size of first matrix and column size of first matrix, row size of second matrix and column size of second matrix. After that, you check the condition. This condition, what is this condition? If R1 equal to R2 and C1 equal to C2, after that only you write this logic. And after this, else you write the matrix multiplication is not possible. After that, here write else matrix multiplication is not possible. in that case, when you declare your sizes, different sizes for different matrices, okay? If you declare same R1, R and C for two matrices, if you take R sizes for first matrix, row size of first matrix and row size of second matrix, C is the column size of first matrix and column size of second matrix, no need to check the condition because R and C are same for each. So, no need of taking different sizes for that. You can do that way, you can do this way. So, these are multiple possibilities of matrix addition. So, remember that and do as you wish. Okay, and we'll see the example execution of this program we have done. So, same thing I have done. Int A of 3 by 3, B of 3 by 3, C of 3 by 3, I, J and print F, enter the first matrix element. The same thing, what is the we have explained here, there, I've explained there, the same thing I've copy pasted here. We'll see how it will be executed. So, compile. So, yes, I've compiled it, it is successfully compiled. So, execute. So, run. So, I'm running that matrix. It is asking to enter the first matrix element. I'm entering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many elements will be there? 3 by 3. So, 9 elements. So, it is asking to enter the second matrix. So, what is the second matrix? Same. So, I am entering reverse. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So, I am giving a reverse order because I get the same value. What is the 10, 10, 10, 10? I should get the addition up. So, 1 plus this is the first element 1 plus 9 is equal to 10, 2 plus 8 is equal to 10, 3 plus 7 is equal to 10. Likewise, I have to get same value for that. We'll see, is that I'm getting the same output or not. So, see. So, what is the output I'm getting? 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10 by 10. So, all matrix elements are 10, 10, 10, 10. So, this is my result. So, this as I explained, same thing. Compile this program or execute this program. The size of this matrix will be same for this. So 3 by 3, 3 by 3, 3 by 3, 3 by 3. So, all the elements will be 9 elements, 9. So, every time I execute the program, I have to take only 9 elements. I have to read 9 elements of A matrix, 9 elements of B matrix, 9 elements. So, I have to get the 9 elements. But I want to change my size dynamically when I execute the program. So, if I want to, first time while I'll execute, I'll take only 2 by 3 matrix. Next time, I'll take 3 by 3 matrix. So, in that case, how I can do that? So, change the size to maximum. So there will not be 10 by 10 matrix. So, maximum size, that is, you can also take. So, 100 by 100 also, I'm taking only 10 by 10. So, I'm not take more than 10 by 10 size. That's the reason I'm taking 10 by 10. So, I'm declaring a maximum size 10 by 10 of every matrix and taking another two variables called R, C. So, these are the two variables to read a row size and column size. So, I'm entering the So, I am asking to user. So, why should I ask? I would ask the user before the until unless I don't know what is the value of row size and column size, percentile D and percentile D. So, because both are integer variables. So, that's the reason I have taken percentile D and percentile D. So, integer variables ampersand R, ampersand C. Okay, these are the two variables. So, I have read the row size and column size. This is the one case, I am telling. This is the one case, row size and column size for both matrices. R is the row size for first matrix, R is the column size for second matrix. C is the row size for column first matrix, C is the column size for second matrix. If it is this case, so what I have to change? I have to change here, R, row size and column, C. So, here C, what happens here? Sorry. So what happened here? C is a variable for variable name for array is there. C is a variable name for this also there. So I'm changing this to resultant matrix R. RES resultant. So if you change the resultant, so this is the resultant matrix will be there, and I'm going to take same way. So okay. So R and every time remember whenever declaring your variables should be unique for every type. So, if same variable should not be repeated for variable name, should not be repeated for multiple variables. Okay, remember that and you do it. So, okay, R is the row size of this first matrix I have done. So, I have taken the row size, column size, first and second matrix. And the same, I am taking a row and column. So, B matrix I have read and again here, row and column. Here, I have to change to C to RES because I have changed my variable name to RES. So here row size and column size, and to print res. So res, so save. Okay, so res, the resultant, we'll see what is the result we'll be printing. Okay, save, compile. So scan wherever it is. So error. So I'm saving it. Compile. Yes. Everything is right. I'm going to run it. So run. So it is asking to enter the row size and column size of my matrices. So I'm entering. So now I'll take only 2x3 matrix. Okay. So let's take 2x3 matrix. So what is the first element? How many elements have to enter? 2x3. 6 elements have to enter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next, I'm giving the result reverse way. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Because it makes us easy to compile. So is it giving correct or not? That's the reason I'm taking the result reverse way. See, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7. So how many rows? 2 rows and 3 columns are the output of this matrix. And this is another case. If at all, in another case, there is also another case where you have a different row size for a different matrix. For example, if A have one row size, column size, and B have another row size, column size. And if at all in this case, in that case, what I have to do is I am writing here R1, C1, taking R2, C2. What happens here? Column size of row and column size of first matrix. I am asking first matrix. So at the same way, R1 and C1. So second copy and enter the row size, column size of second matrix. What happens now? It have to change R2, C2. So what it does? What is the condition I have to check before that? Because so only addition is possible if at all both row size and column size are equal and column size of both row size are equal. Okay. So if it in this case, if I'm checking the condition, if R1 is equal to R2 and C1 equal to C2. So in this case only my addition is possible. Yes. So in that case only I'll read matrix sizes. And after that only, I'll compile a compute resultant matrix. If both are not equal, that is row size, column size is not equal, I cannot read the row size. No need to read the matrices, and no need to compile the result also. No need to print that. So for that reason, I'm writing else. So printf. Addition is not possible. This is my another case, okay? So where both sizes, row size and column size are equal. So R1, C1, so this is R2, C2. So here in the result, what it will be? R1, C1, anything you can write. So because both, if it both are equal only, I'll get the output. So it is asking enter the row size, column size of first matrix. I'm taking 2x3. So if I take 3x4, addition is not possible. So I cannot perform addition. So we have to give in this way also. So this is another case where we have different row size and column size for different matrices. Okay. So up to this, we cover it. We'll see in the next class. Okay. Thank you.